This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. 1. French Land Register Data, which excludes lakes, ponds, glaciers. 15. Modern Europe 2. Geography 21. Location 22. Topography 23. Climate 24. Districts 25. Parks and gardens 3. Population 4. Government and politics 5. Economy 6. Education 7. Culture 71. Sites of interest 711. Other institutions 712. Performing arts centers 72. Annual cultural events and fairs 73. Sports 8. Transport 81. Road 82, air 83. Rail 84. Tram 85. Bus 9. Berths 10. Literary references 11. International relations 111. Twin towns, sister cities 12. See also 13. References 14. External links history. See also timeline of Besançon toponymy. The city is first recorded in 58 BC as Vesontio in the Book 1 of Julius Caesar's Commentary de Bello Gallico. The etymology of Vesontio is uncertain. The most common explanation is that the name is of Celtic origin, derived from Wes, meaning mountain during the 4th century, the letter B took the place of the V, and the city name changed to Besançon or Bisanzon and then underwent several transformations to become Besançon in 1243. The Doubs River and the Quai Vauban seen from the Pont Batten. Ancient history. The city sits within an oxbow of the Doubs River, a tributary of the Saone River. A mountain closes the fourth side during the Bronze Age, c. 1500 BCE. Tribes of Gauls settled the oxbow from the 1st century BC through the modern era. The town had a significant military importance because the Alps rise abruptly to its immediate south, presenting a significant natural barrier. The Aar Saone River formed part of the border between the Haedui and their hereditary rivals, the sqmi. According to Strabo, the cause of the conflict was commercial. Each tribe claimed the Aar and the tolls on trade along it. The sqmi controlled access to the Rhine River and had built an oppidum, a fortified town at Vesontio, to protect their interests. The sqmi defeated and massacred the Haedui at the Battle of Magetabriga, with the help of the Arverni tribe and the Germanic Subi tribe under the Germanic king Ariovistus. Julius Caesar, in his commentaries detailing his conquest of Gaul, describes Vesontio, possibly Latinized, as the largest town of the sqmi, a smaller Gallic tribe, and mentions that a wooden palisade surrounded it. Over the centuries, the name permutated to become Besantio, Besançon, Bisanz in Middle High German, and gradually arrived at the modern French Besançon. The locals retain their ancient heritage, referring to themselves as Bisantins feminine, Bisantine. It has been an archbishopric since the 4th century Middle Ages. Henry II, Holy Roman Emperor, inherited the city and made it part of the Holy Roman Empire in 1032. In 843, the Treaty of Verdun divided up Charlemagne's empire. Besançon became part of Lotharingie, under the Duke of Burgundy, as part of the Holy Roman Empire. Since 1034, the city became an archbishopric, and was designated the Free Imperial City of Besançon, an autonomous city-state under the Holy Roman Emperor in 1184. In 1157, Emperor Frederick Barbarossa held the Diet of Besançon there. Cardinal Orlando Bandinelli, the future Pope Alexander III, then advisor of Pope Adrian IV, openly asserted before the Emperor that the imperial dignity was a papal beneficium in the more general sense of favor, not the strict feudal sense of fief, which incurred the wrath of the German princes. He would have fallen on the spot under the battle axe of his lifelong foe, Otto of Wittelsbach, had Frederick not intervened. The imperial chancellor Reinald of Dassel then inaugurated a German policy that insisted upon the rights and the power of the German kings, the strengthening of the church in the German Empire, the lordship of Italy, and the humiliation of the papacy. The archbishops were elevated to princes of the Holy Roman Empire in 1288. The close connection to the empire is reflected in the city's coat of arms in 1290. After a century of fighting against the power of the archbishops, the emperor granted Besançon its independence. Renaissance in the 15th century. Besançon came under the influence of the Dukes of Burgundy after the marriage of Mary of Burgundy to Maximilian I, Holy Roman Emperor. The city was in effect a Habsburg fief in 1519. Charles V, Holy Roman Emperor, King of Spain, became the Holy Roman Emperor. This made him master of Franche-Comté and Besançon, a francophone German city. In 1526, the city obtained the right to mint coins, which it continued to strike until 1673. Nevertheless, all coins bore the name of Charles V. When Charles V abdicated in 1555, 1305, he gave Franche-Comté to his son, Philip II, King of Spain. Besançon remained a free imperial city under the protection of the King of Spain in 1598. Philip II gave the province to his daughter on her marriage to an Austrian archduke. It remained formally a portion of the empire until its cession at the Peace of Westphalia in 1648. Spain regained control of Franche-Comté and the city lost its status as a free city then in 1667, Louis XIV claimed the province as a consequence of his marriage to Marie Thérèse of Spain in the War of Devolution. Louis conquered the city for the first time in 1668, but the Treaty of Aix-la-Chapelle returned it to Spain within a matter of months while it was in French hands. The famed military engineer Vauban visited the city and drew up plans for its fortification. The Spaniards built the main center point of the city's defenses, La Citadel, siting it on Mont Saint-Étienne, which closes the neck of the Oxbow that is the site of the original town. In their construction, the Spaniards followed Vauban's designs. In 1674, French troops recaptured the city, which the Treaty of Nijmegen 1678 then awarded to France. At this time, the city became the administrative centre for Franche-Comté, with its own Parliament of Besançon, which replaced Dole. The citadel of Besançon by Vauban as a result of control passing to France. Vauban returned to working on the citadel's fortifications, and those of the city. This process lasted until 1711, some 30 years, and the walls built then surround the city between the train station and the central city. There is a complex moat system that now serves road traffic. Numerous forts, some of which date back to that time and that incorporate Vauban's designs elements, sit on the six hills that surround the city: Fort de Trois Châtels, Fort Chaudane, Fort du Petit Chaudane, Fort Griffin, Fort des Justices, Fort de Beauregard and Fort de Bréguil. The citadel itself has two dry moats, with an outer and inner court in the evenings. The illuminated citadel stands above the city as a landmark and a testament to Vauban's genius as a military engineer. Modern Europe. In 1814, the Austrians invaded and bombarded the city. It also occupied an important position during the Franco-Prussian War of 1870-71. The Nazis occupied the citadel during World War II between 1940 and 1944. The Germans executed some 100 French resistance fighters there. However, Besançon saw little action during the war. The Allies bombed the railway complex in 1943, and the next year the Germans resisted the U.S. advance for 4 days. Besançon was also the location, between 1940 and 1941, of an internment camp Konzentrationslager, Frontzelag 142, also known as Kaserne Vauban, which the Germans set up for 3,000-4,000 holders of British passports, all women and children. The conditions were harsh. Many hundreds of internees died of pneumonia, diarrhea, food poisoning, dysentery, and frostbite. In 1959, the French army turned the citadel over to the city of Besançon, which turned it into a museum. The forts of Bréguil and Beauregard sit across the Doubs from the city. In 1913, a private company built a funicular to the Bréguil Heights. The funicular passed from private ownership to the SNCF, who finally closed it in 1987. The funicular's tracks, stations and even road signs remain in place to this day. Geography. Site of Besançon. Landsat 7. Besançon, seen by SPOT satellite location. Besançon is located in the northeast quarter of France on the Doubs River. It is about 325 kilometers 202 miles east of the national capital of Paris, 100 kilometers 62 miles east of Dijon in Burgundy, 125. Chaudane, Montfaucon, and Montboucon. There is a barge canal that cuts through rock under Mont Saint-Étienne, shortcutting the meander climate. Besançon is under the influence of both an oceanic climate, notable precipitations in quantity as much as in frequency, and a continental climate with hard winters, snow, frost and warm and dry summers. The year-round average is 115. June, July, August, September, October, November, December. Year record high degree C degree F 168 septillion 622 sextillion 217 quintillion 711 quadrillion 248 trillion 766 billion 291,844,322. 93-52-954-403-1045-383-1009-346-943-301-862-208-694-403-1045. Average high degree C degree F 52-414-70-446-114-525-155-152-594-195-671-228-73-253-775-250-77-207-207-693. 1-60-608-95-491-57-423-153-595 Average low degree C degree F minus 07-307-02-316-27-369-52-414-93. 487 quadrillion 124 trillion 543 billion 145 million 581,141 574-109-516-76-457-29-372-04-327-66-439 Record low degree C degree F. Minus 207 minus 53 minus 206 minus 51 minus 140 68 minus 52226 minus 24 277 21 358 45 401 34 381 minus 01 318 Minus 6121 minus 113117 minus 193 minus 27 minus 207 minus 53 Average precipitation m inches 863-339-8-797-313-820-3622-942-3709-1148 452-105-3996-900-3543-919-361-8-1072-422-1157-455-5-104-5-4114-102-429-1486-732 Average precipitation days. 130,116,121,115,134-111-102-100-98-125-126-134-1410 Average relative humidity percent 87-82-77-74 77-77-75-78-82-87-87-88-809 Mean monthly sunshine hours 751-955-1421-1761-2066-2304-2441-2323 1758-1326-727-530-1-8364 Source number 1, Meteo France Source number 2, Infoclimate for Humidity, 1961-1990 Districts Courtyard of the former City Hall The 14 Besançon Boroughs Center, Chapelle des Bizvalottes Buttes, Gret Batten Chaprais, Crasse Breguil Saint Ferjo, Rosemont. Montboucans, Montrepin-Saint-Claude, Torcalls-Palente, Orchamps, Saragosse-Vites, Claire-Soleil's-Planoise, Châteauferine-Tilleroy's-Chalas-Centre The Buckleet and Saint-Jean, Chapelle des Bis-Batten-Breguil-Vites, Claire-Soleil's-Vallotte-Butte, Gret-Chaprais, Crasse-Palente, Orchamps, Coombe-Saragosse-Tilleroy's-Montrepin, Montboucans, Fontaine-Écu-Planoise, Châteauferine. Saint Claude, Torcalls Saint Ferjo, Rosemont Chalas Parks and Gardens Jardin Botanique de Besançon Parc Maco Parc de la Guerre d'Eau Parc de la Citadel Promenade Granville Promenade Chamars Population as of the French census of 2012, the population of the city of Besançon was 116,353, lower than the historical peak of 120,315 in 1975 Grand Besançon covers 122. Year pop plus or minus percent 1828,436. 1896 57,556 58% 1911 57,978 07% 1921 55,652 minus 40% 1936 65,022 168% 1946 63,508 minus 23% 1954 73,445 156%. 1962 95,642 302% 1968 113,220 184% 1975 120,315 63% 1982 113,283 minus 58% 1990 113,828 05% 1999 117,733 34% 2008 117,599-01% 2012 116,353-11% Government and politics. Besançon is the capital of the Franche-Comté region of France, a région including the four départements of Doubs, Haute-Saône, Jura and Territoire de Belfort. As such, it is the seat of the Franche-Comté Regional Council, and the regional prefecture government offices. Mayor of the city of Besançon is Jean-Louis Fauzeret. Economy. The city is famous for its microtechnology and watch industries. It is host of the biannual Micronora Trade Fair, one of Europe's major events in the field of microtechnologies. The city has a little-known specialty, automatic ticketing machines for car parking, airports, date stamping, etc. The watch industry, for which Besançon remains the French capital, endured a major crisis. In the 1970s, when the advent of quartz watches from Asia knocked out the traditional watch industry in the space of just a few years, the famous Lip affair epitomizes the industrial crisis. Lip is to this day the name of one of Besançon's most prestigious brands of watches, refusing to let their factory close. The workers set up a cooperative to run it. The action produced a lot of notoriety and sympathy for the workers, but also resulted in branding Besançon as a city of the radical left. It also did nothing to help revive the watch industry. The cooperative went out of business a short while later. The city took a long time to recover from the collapse of the watch industry and its other major industry of the industrial age, artificial textiles. Since the 1980s, Besançon's watch industry has clawed its way back on the basis of its historic reputation and quartz watches, establishing itself in a number of niche markets including customized watches, high-quality watches, and fashion articles. Since the 1990s, the town has developed a reputation as one of France's leading centers of technology in all fields, including telecommunications and biotechnology education. Besançon is the seat of the Université de Franche-Comté. As of 2006, there were approximately 20,000 students enrolled at the university, including around 3,000 foreign students. The Institut Supérieur d'Ingénieurs de Franche-Comté ISIFC, part of the Université de Franche-Comté, is the first school created in the country specifically for the biomedical engineering field. The city is also home of the École Nationale Supérieure de Mécanique et des Microtechniques ENSMM, a technological school with a strong reputation in the fields of microtechnology and mechanics, and the worldwide famous Centre for Applied Linguistics, which teaches 10 languages to non-native speakers: French, Arabic, Chinese, English, German, Italian, Japanese, Portuguese, Russian, Spanish, and any other known language on request, and which welcomes more than 4,000 students every year from all over the world. Culture fountain on the Place Jean Cornet. General view of the old city. Sites of interest. Interior of Saint Jean Cathedral in Besançon. General view of Vauban Citadel. Typical products of the region. The Port Noire, Roman triumphal arch. Detail of the multicolored stone from Chayla's quarry, used in many of the buildings. The city has one of the most beautiful historic centers of any major town in France. A broad horseshoe of the river Doubs, La Boucle, encircles the old town, while Vauban's imposing citadel blocks off the neck. The historic center presents a remarkable ensemble of classic stone buildings, some dating back to the Middle Ages and others to the Spanish Renaissance. Among its most visited historic monuments are several Roman remains, the 16th-century Palais Granville, Vauban Citadel, Citadel of Besançon, the Cathedral of Saint Jean, several Spanish Renaissance-style buildings, the Église de la Madeleine, and the river frontage. The Roman remains consist primarily of the Port Noire, a 2nd-century CE triumphal arch at the foot of the hill on which the citadel stands, and the square Castan, a semicircular amphitheater. The Port Noire may commemorate the victories of Marcus Aurelius over the Germans in 167 CE. It was partly rebuilt in 1820 from 1534 to 1540. Cardinal Granville, chancellor to the Habsburg Emperor Charles V, built the Palais Granville. In the heart of the town, it consists of arcades that surround an interior court, and is the most interesting of the secular buildings. The Palais contains a set of 7 wool and silk blend tapestries from Bruges that were woven circa 1635 and that celebrate 7 milestones in Charles V's life. These tapestries remained in Spain until 1888, when they were transferred to France. In 1950, they were transferred to the Palais. UNESCO added the citadel, the city walls, and Fort Griffin to its list of World Heritage Sites in 2008. As part of the Fortifications of Vauban group, some older military architecture has also survived. There is a cylindrical, 15th-century tower near the Port Notre Dame, the southern gate of the city. The Port Rivet, a 16th-century gate, has 2 round towers. The citadel houses the Museum of the French Resistance and Deportation. The cathedral, which dates largely from the 12th century though construction continued into the 14th century, contains the most remarkable of the city's masterpieces, a massive Virgin and Saints altarpiece by the Italian Renaissance painter Fra Bartolomeo. It also houses a noteworthy 19th century astronomical clock. The cathedral has two apses, with the eastern apse and the tower dating from the reign of Louis XV. Attractive quays border the old city, and in places there are shady promenades on the right bank. There is a bathing establishment in the Müller Quarter that draws its water from the saline springs of Misery. Salines. Besançon also has one of the finest city art galleries in France outside Paris. The Museum of Fine Arts and Archaeology has a collection whose origins date to 1694, and which a remarkable series of bequests have augmented over time. In the 1960s, the architect Louis Michel, a pupil of Le Corbusier, totally rebuilt the building. The building's interior takes the form of a gently rising concrete walkway that takes visitors up from classical antiquity to the modern age. Among the museum's treasures are a fine collection of classical antiquities and ancient Egyptian artifacts, as well as a very rich collection of paintings including works by Bellini, Bronzino, Tintoretto, Titian, Rubens, Jordaens, Ruisdael, Cranach, Zurbarán, Goya, Philippe de Champagne, Fragonard, Boucher, David, Ingres, Géricault, Corbett, Constable, Bonnard, Matisse, Picasso and many others. Museum of Fine Arts and Archaeology, as well as being famed as one of France's finest villes d'art art cities, Besançon is the seat of one of France's older universities, of France's National School of Mechanics and Micromechanics, and one of the best-known French-language schools in France, the CLA. It is also reputed to be France's environmentally friendliest city, with a public transport network that has often been cited as a model on account of the topography. The historic city centre lies at the edge of the modern city, and hiking tracks lead straight from the centre and up into the surrounding hills. The city council has been in the hands of the socialists and parties of the left since the Second World War. King Willem Alexander of the Netherlands is also the Lord of Besançon. The Christmas carol, Burger, Secoué ton sommeil profond, known in English as Shepherds. Shake off your drowsy sleep, originated in Besançon in the 17th century. Other institutions: Museum of Time, Museum of Franche-Comté, Museum of Natural History, which contains a zoo, aquarium, insectarium, noctarium, and a climatology exhibit. Besançon Astronomical Observatory, Performing Arts Centers, Nouveau Théâtre, Opéra Théâtre, construit par le Duc de 1778 à 1784, Grand Cursal, Nouveau Théâtre, Centre Dramatique, National Cirque, Plume Théâtre, Bacchus Théâtre de la Boulevard, Théâtre de l'Espace. Annual cultural events and fairs. Several major events occur annually in Besançon. One of the best known is the Besançon International Music Festival, which takes place in September. It is one of the oldest and most prestigious classical music festivals. Besançon hosts other music festivals such as the Herb and Zik Festival, French Rock and Variety in May, the Jazz and Franche-Comté Festival in June, the French Country Festival Country Music in August, and the Musiques de Rue Festival Street Music in October. Sports. The major sports in Besançon are soccer, handball and basketball. The city's soccer club, called Besançon Racing Club, plays in the French 7th Division. The city has also the International Football Academy of Orchamps Besançon for young players from 4 to 13 years, labeled by the French Football Federation since the creation of the label in 2004. Its purpose is to teach young players in all aspects of football to become good competitive players. ASOB Foot. Besançon also had a fairly successful hockey team in the early 21st century. The Sequanes, named after an ancient Gallic tribe, reached the French Cup final in 2002, which the city hosted and briefly played in the country's top league, then called Super 16. However, the Sequanes' free spending policy soon backfired. The team folded in the middle of the 2002-03 season due to financial problems. Today, senior hockey subsists in Besançon in the form of a low-level amateur team. The city also had a good canoe-kayak club, Sport Nautique Bicentin. One of the oldest in France. Club Sport League Stadium. Besançon Racing Club. Football Championnat de France Amateur Stade Léo Lagrange. Entente Sportive Bicentine. Miscalan Handball Nationale 1 Gymnase des Montboucans. Entente Sportive Bicentine. Feminine Handball Division 1 Women's Palais des Sports. Transport. Road Besançon is situated at the crossing of two major lines of communication, the NASW route that follows the valley of the river Doubs and links Germany and North Europe with Lyon and Southwest Europe, and the NS route linking northern France and the Netherlands with Switzerland. Air unusually for a city of its size, Besançon does not have a commercial airport. Two international airports, Euroairport Basel Mulhouse Freiburg and Lyon Saint-Exupéry International Airport, are about 2 hours away by car rail. Besançon is well connected with the rest of France by train. One can reach major destinations such as Paris, Dijon, Belfort, Mulhouse, Strasbourg, Lyon, Marseille, Montpellier and Lille directly. The city has some international connections to cities such as Basel and Zurich in Switzerland and Frankfurt am Main in Germany. Gare de Besançon Viat, the main railway station, sits in the center of the city. Gare de Besançon French and Arpitan TGV is the high-speed railway station and it sits some 10. A tramway commenced service in September 2014. The length of the line is 13 km 81. Michel Blavet 1700-1768, flutist, composer Charles Fourier 1772-1837, inventor of socialist phalansteries, vast communal buildings surrounded by a highly cultivated agricultural area. Charles Etienne François Rutty 1777-1828, Comte, general, peer, commissioned into the army in 1793 and promoted to Lt. General in 1813. Charles Weiss 1779-1866, librarian and bibliographer. Charles Nodier 1780-1844, writer, leader of the Romantic movement. Jean-Claude Eugène Paquelet 1793-1857, physicist, gave his name to the Paquelet number. Victor Hugo 1802-1885, writer and poet. Pierre-Joseph Proudhon 1809-1865, politician, economist and author, theorist of anarchism. Adolphe Braun 1812-1877, early photographer. Marie-Louise Outhwaite née Roger 1814-1905, prominent early settler of Auckland, New Zealand. Hilaire de Chardonnet 1838-1924, inventor of artificial silk. Henry Aaron 1842-1885, journalist. Louis Jean Raisel 1854-1920, engineer who built the Pont Mirabeau and the Pont Alexander. Three in Paris. Auguste and Louis Lumière 1862-1954 and 1864-1948, inventors of cinematography. Tristan Bernard 1866-1947, journalist and humorist. Albert Seitz 1872-1937, composer and violist. Ludovic Arichart 1897-1933, aviator. Jean de Gribaldi 1922-1987, professional racing cyclist and director. Sportif Raymond Blanc born 1949, Chef Mourad Hakkar born 1972, boxer Gaspard Auger born 1979, one half of electronic music duo Justice Cyril Calli, footballer Johan Lassiment, footballer Lucien Laurent, footballer. Literary references. Julius Caesar, in his account Commentary de Bello Gallico, gives a description of the antique city of Besançon, named Vesontio. First book, section 38, when he had proceeded 3 days' journey, word was brought to him that Ariovistus was hastening with all his forces to seize on Besançon, which is the largest town of the sqmi, and had advanced 3 days' journey from its territories. Caesar thought that he ought to take